Hey, this is Amy Lee from Evanescence, and you're listening to Asia Pop 40.
Asia Pop 40!
Yeah, I gotta say, I mean, I'm in my mid-30s, same with you, around the same age range. So we grew up with some really dark stuff as kids, and nowadays you look around, everything is happy-go-lucky, you know, you have basically Frozen's always end on a happy note. How do you think that's gonna change the kids in the next generation?
I don't know. I mean, it's hard to say. Like, our imaginations are gonna go wild no matter what, I think. There were darker tones in the 80s a lot, like in a place for kids, where now, like, as a mom, I see like red flag all over the place with the stuff that I was into. But at the same time, like, just letting it be okay, I wonder, you know, like, from an artistic level, letting it be okay to imagine and letting it be okay to be a little bit exposed to themes like death, you know, the fact that it's going to happen, we're going to be exposed to it sometime. I don't know what the right moment is, but I don't know. It's a weird question. Like, is it better to be able to explore a little bit so that it's not so scary? You know, I don't know. Music for me has always been a cool outlet, for darker stuff, but it, because I have that, I'm not really a depressed person normally. I feel like a fairly balanced person. I think that's the best way to put it. But having an outlet to be able to, release some of that stuff and talk about it really helps me.
Yeah, and I feel like that the idea we just actually started talking about is maybe the motif of your new album, Bitter Truth. It's sometimes you gotta be told the bitter truth on an early age, you know, like in Dumbo and Bambi, that kind of stuff. Is that what it's actually about?
It wasn't about the young age part, but just about not living in denial. There's a lot of lies in the world right now. And I am definitely facing a moment where I just want truth. And sometimes, oftentimes, it is more bitter to know the truth, but so much better than, I don't know, being under someone else's control or not knowing what's going on or living in a bubble and not actually tasting life. I'd rather have the truth. And it's also just about growing up, you know, going, all right, somebody's got to be the grown-up here. Let's do this. And then you can really experience what's going on around you, right? But it does take living through things, you know, to get there.
I think a little bit of disillusionment is necessary to grow, to evolve. You know, what's the age-old saying? You got to have thesis, antithesis to have synthesis, right? And okay, so let's talk about the album and the writing process, because I'm pretty sure the songs are done. The writing process is through now. You're just waiting for production, or are you still writing?
No, we're still writing.
Okay, so
we have two this week that we just started up. Yeah, we're still writing.
So you're all writing from home. I'm curious, where is Amy's favorite place to write at home? Is it the porch? Is it the kitchen?
I'm in my studio right now. I usually write here. I've got a lot of keyboards here. I have Pro Tools happening.
Nice.
And all my toys when I was in high school, they're up on the shelves, and Rainbow Bright makes an appearance as well. Anyway. Yeah, I've got everything that I need here to throw a scratch down. I can't do everything the band can do, obviously. So my role is usually coming up with like the basic like skeletons, like the lyrics, like the vocal melodies and the chord progressions. And then from there, it's like, all right, who's got an idea? Or sometimes it starts with a riff or a drum beat first. Beats are usually a good inspiration for me, but I like to go through just my synth libraries and sample libraries, and like listen for sounds and beat ideas, and then just start singing over them sometimes and create something that's usually sounds much more electronic than it does in the end.
Yeah.
And then we turn it into a rock song together, but sometimes some of those parts stay.
Okay, well, we can't wait because, like you said, the synthesis project is going to carry over into this one, which means a little bit of rock, a little bit of orchestral arrangement, maybe, and a little bit more electronics.
I don't know if I'm going to say that. No, I actually feel like the synthesis project pushed us a little bit to the other side. It made the pendulum swing back.
Oh, okay.
So far, the songs that we've recorded so far, we haven't wanted any orchestra. I think there will be definitely a time for it. It's been so long since we put out music. This needs to sort of have all the elements present.
Yeah.
But so far, it's been rock and electronic.
Looking forward to it. Looking forward to it. Do we have a ballpark of release dates? And I mean, I know you're working on it furiously. I don't want to put a pressure or light a fire under
you. This year, we're just gonna keep releasing one by ones for a little while.
Okay.
And the plan is to drop like the back half of it by the end of the year, and just be like, okay, here's the whole thing. So I don't know exact date yet. We kind of have to wait on what's going on, but we're just gonna keep releasing what we have and recording what we can and get it out when it's done.
All right, well, there you heard it from Amy herself. Evanescence with a new project, fifth full LP, The Bitter Truth, coming out sometime in the back half of 2020. And Amy, thank you so much for joining us here.
Thank you. Thank you. Thanks for talking to me, Joey. Hey, this is Amy Lee from Evanescence, and you're listening to Asia Pop 40. Asia Pop 40.